C, applications of human genome project. So in what way human genome project will be useful for the human beings? So what are the applications of human genome project? Sir, here in the human genome project, when we identify the genome of the human beings, we can identify genetical disorders and what are the reasons for the genetical disorders. So here in the, with the help of human genome project, we can identify the genetical disorders and how can we treat this, that genetical disorders, that is we can study. Next, so here when you know the human genome, we can improve the tools. We can improve the tools for the treatment of genetical disorders. Treatment of genetical disorders. Okay, na? So that is application. Next one, after the human genome project, so many animals' DNA was sequenced. So when you know the total genome of an individual, so here we can replace the damaged gene with the healthy gene. So we can perform gene therapy. Gene therapy. So when the development of DNA sequencing was started, it caused development of a new branch, that is bioinformatics. Bioinformatics. And here this human genome project has its application in so many ethical, social, legal and social issues. We are applying this human genome project. Sir, here we are using for recombinant DNA technology. First thing is, it is used for genetical disorders. What are the reasons for the genetical disorders and what are the remedies for the genetical disorders treatment? That is first thing. And we are improving medical treatment for the genetical disorders. Improving treatment and improving of the tools for the treatment of genetical disorders. And gene therapy. Next, development of bioinformatics. And it is used for the solving of ethical, legal, social issues. So these are the applications of the human genome project. Okay, so this is about human genome project. So next topic, if you take DNA fingerprinting. See here, DNA fingerprinting, it is also known as genetic fingerprinting or DNA typing. DNA typing. So DNA fingerprinting, genetic fingerprinting, DNA typing. These are all same words. So what is DNA fingerprinting? Why it is called as DNA fingerprinting? How the fingerprints are unique to an individual? No two individuals have same fingerprints, isn't it? No two individuals have same fingerprints. In the same way, no two individuals have same genome. Isn't it? So no two individuals, even if you take except identical twins, the human genome is different in all the other individuals. So how the fingerprints are unique, DNA is also unique. So when you are identifying the difference between the two individuals is called as DNA fingerprinting. DNA fingerprinting is nothing but identification of the differences between the two individuals' DNA is called as DNA fingerprinting. Sir, you said 99% of the DNA is unique in all individuals, means same in all individual. Only 1% is different. How much percentage is different? Only 1% is different. Means most of the individuals have some unique sequences. Most of the individuals have some unique sequences. So they are called as restricted fragment lengthy polymorphism. Lengthy polymorphism. So this is called as RFLP. This is called as RFLP. Restricted fragment lengthy polymorphism. So these are the sequences which present in only one individual. They are differ from other individuals. So generally these are called as reflips. There are some special sequences which are present in one individual's genome, which are absent on the another individual's genome, are called as restricted fragment lengthy polymorphism. And these are called as also reflips. These are considered as genetic markers. These are called as genetic markers. So these genetic markers are different from one individual to another individual. So these are different from one individual to the another individual. Okay, now next. So here generally these are also called as VNTRS. Sir, some of the individuals have single nucleotide repeated DNA sequences or single nucleotide repeating sequences. They are called as SNPs. SNPs are present in an individual. But what are RFLP? They are variable in number tandem repeats. What is VNTRS? Variable number in tandem repeats is called as RFLPs. So these are unique to individual. So here, if you are able to identify these sequences, we can identify the DNA of one individual which is different from another individual. Okay, now so this is DNA fingerprinting introduction. Actually, Alec Jeffries. So Alec Jeffries is a Britain scientist. So Alec Jeffries, who is a Britain scientist, he developed DNA fingerprinting technology. He improved the DNA fingerprinting technology while he was working on myoglobin protein. So while he was working on which? Myoglobin. So he improved DNA fingerprinting technology, which is used for the, which is used for the identification of the DNA with the another individual's DNA. Okay, means each and every individual has some unique sequences. If you are able to identify that unique sequences with the comparison of another individual, you can tally the individual's DNA. Then you can identify the similar DNA, whether it is differ DNA. Okay, now so let us see steps in DNA fingerprinting technology. This is very important 4 marks question. So the steps involved in the DNA fingerprinting technology. First, let's see. First point is obtaining of DNA. What is the first step? Obtaining of DNA, sir. See here, the DNA can be obtained. That may be a crime, that may be taxonomic, that may be pedigree, that may be anything. So DNA can be obtained from the blood, semen, hair roots, which are available in the site or scene. So obtaining of DNA is nothing but collection of DNA from the sources. The sources may be blood, the sources may be semen, that may be hair follicles or hair roots. These are all the sources for the DNA. So DNA is taken first. Second thing is fragmentation of DNA. Fragmentation of DNA. Okay, so here fragmentation of DNA, if you see, by the usage of restriction endonucleases. Restriction endonucleases. So by the usage of restriction endonucleases, DNA is fragmented into small fragments.